भगवते वासुदेवाय धीमहि प्रद्युम्नाय निरुद्धाय नमः संकर्षणाय च नमो विज्ञानमात्राय परमानन्दमूर्तये आत्मा रामाय शांताय निवृत्तद्वैतदृष्टये सी नमो विज्ञानमात्राय परमानन्दमूर्तये Understand where, what is Jnana and what is Vijnana, what is knowledge and what is wisdom? Knowledge. Any knowledge that is produced through thoughts is called Jnana. Any knowledge, and which is that knowledge? That is self-knowledge. Of the self, which cannot be produced by the thought and yet is continuously existing, is called Vijnana. Is continuously presenting itself is Vijnana. And therefore, Namo Vijnana Matraya. So, to that, where the thoughts cannot reach, and where in that Vijnana, in that intellect, where there is abhav, there is absence of all thoughts, there alone this reality or the Lord expresses himself. That Vijnana Matraya, only in a thought-free intellect, when he is recognized as the presence, then alone Paramananda Murtaye, then alone the experience of infinite bliss without a thought will be revealed. Atma Ramaya Shantaya. And this self is continuously revealing in itself, and it is Shant. It is not sometimes becoming peaceful and sometimes it is becoming disturbed. It is neither shanti nor, it is not that shanti which is opposite of ashanti, but it is prashanti, that shantaya, which is, and when do you achieve that shanti? That shanti is attained, that shanti is becomes our nature only when, from our system, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya is completely in toto removed. How it is removed? Not by you removing them one by one. It is removed by the grace, and for that grace to flow, you have to make your intellect direct towards the Om Namo, Om Namastubhyam Bhagavate Vasudevaya Dhimahi. Then alone it will happen. Otherwise it will not. Don't try to clear your mind of something. If you clear it, it will come back with double speed. But when it is removed by the grace of the divine, and that grace is because you are putting attention, you can't put attention, but you are thinking still through the mind, it starts happening. Nivritta dvaita drishtraya, in such a person, the nivritti takes place. Nivritti means withdrawal takes place, withdrawal of the intellect or the mind takes place, and in such a person or in such a mind, there is no duality ever present hereafter or thereafter. Atmanandanubhutyaiva, and such a person, as a result of this, a person is continuously revealing in himself. In what? Himself, which self? The Atma, the Lord, the Divine. Nyasta shaktya, shaktyur maye namaha, rishikeshaya mahate namaste vishwamurtaye. To that Lord, who is the controller of all the senses, to that one who is continuously revealing in himself, to that one who is Prashanti Swarup, to that one who is Vijnana Matraya, to that one who is Paramananda. I am telling both ways. First, you also recognize yourself to be that, but if you are in the mind thinking about it, the one who is continuously revealing, to that Namaste Vishwamurtaye, my prostrations to that Vishwamurti. Who is Vishwamurti? He is the one who is expressing as the entire creation. He is the Lord of the entire creation. This is the first manifest. Vachas Yuparate Aprapya Ya Eko Manasasaha. He is that where even the speech cannot reach. And here we told about the Vaikari Madhyama, we told about that last time, I think. So how does speech withdraw? Mind and speech are not two, they are one and the same. Expressed mind is speech, withdrawn speech is mind. Mind cannot express without speech, meaning words. So sometimes the words are subtle. Now we understand, oh, how can be mind? Mind is thoughts only, but those thoughts at its grossest manifestation is words. So therefore Vaikari is the gross manifestation of the speech, what I am using right now. So instead of talking about any unnecessary thing, let that speech be utilized for taking the name of the Lord, singing the glory of the Lord, talking about the Lord. Therefore we are all here. Then as you take one particular, you see, yes, today I went to this youth class, one boy, he says, Swamiji, I want to ask you something. I said, what? After the class. That's why I got late. But anyway, I came to know you are also coming late. So I said, I'll come later. Maybe come nahi hum. So he came, he says, Swamiji, I was sitting in meditation and I felt I am falling this way, I am falling that way. Dekho. And what is he taking? He says, I have not taken any initiation, but I felt that I felt very comfortable with Om Namaste, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. I said, good, take it. How does it matter? Take the name. And this has started happening. I said, fantastic. He didn't know what was happening. He says, I got afraid, I opened my eyes. That is just the beginning stages of body disidentification. Because really, Swamiji? I said, yes, it is like that. I did not know. I was afraid. I thought, where am I falling? But I was not falling. I opened my eyes. My body was absolutely still. It was not even going like this, this way, this way. But inside, the feeling was that I was falling this way. So, to a 20-year-old, when you hear he is going through this, you get inspired, you know. But dekho, Bhagwan ka na, by taking the name of the Lord, this happened. Otherwise, it would not have happened. So, first case is the gross speech, exhausted, 24/7. Automatically, it will become heart chanting. That is called Vaikari Madhyama. Madhyama is when the heart feels very joyful. It doesn't, you can be softly chanting the name of the Lord or grossly chanting, but the name is not just from the vocal cords to the lips. Now it is coming, you know that every time the name is coming, something is happening in your heart. The tears are coming, the hair are standing, there is, every time you take, every now and then, currents of bliss are going through your body. Understand, it has come to, it's moving towards the heart. As you continue taking the name even further, the sound is going back to its source. And what is the source? The divine. Om. So from here, then it migrates slowly, slowly. The channel becomes open, keeps getting clearer and clearer and clearer. It starts coming from the navel. So when you, even when you are laughing, where do you laugh from? So either we are laughing, we can't laugh from here. Laughter always comes from, anand comes from here. The belly goes, isn't it? So that is Pashyanti, that is the third stage. And when it comes to this stage, the speech has gone from gross to subtle, subtle to causal. That is to the unmanifest. At this moment, you don't need to chant loudly. It is continuously going on and it's sometimes stops also. While it is, mind is chanting, at this point the mind is chanting by itself, you are not putting any efforts, but sometimes it stops. And you go into samadhi. Again it stops, it goes into samadhi. And from there, it goes through the kundalini what is called the fourth stage is called the paravani. Vaikari vani, madhyama vani, pashyanti vani and paravani. Paravani and the Lord, they are not two separate things, they are one and the same. So this way, and when it is para, it is beyond unmanifest. This is unmanifest. Beyond this is beyond unmanifest. It cannot, it merges into the divine. And that is the, and therefore, vachasi uparate aprapya, ya eko manasasaha. And anama rupa chin matraha, and this you, who are you? You are without name and without form, so avyana sadasat paraha, and you are the one who is beyond sat and asat, truth and untruth. You are basically here the duality. We are beyond name and form, you are beyond sat and asat, existence and non-existence. Yasmin nidam yadachedam tishtatyapyeti jayate mrunmayeshviva mrujjatihi tasmai te brahmane namaha. And in this way, this universe it arises in you, it stays in you, it merges in you, tishthat yapye pi jayate mrunmayeshva mrujjatihi, and tasmaite brahmane namaha. You are that Brahma in whom, your Brahma means the infinite reality, not Brahmaji. You are that infinite reality in whom the entire universe comes, maintains itself and dissolves itself. And just like the earth in which all the pots are created, maintained and when they dissolve, they go back to the mud, or they go back to the mud. And in this way, yanna spruṣanti na viduhu mano buddhi indriyāsavaha antar bahiśca vitatam vyoma vat tannato smeham. And I bow to that reality which the organs of action fail to reach. What are the organs of action? Speech, hands, legs, anus and genitals. They fail to reach there. They are too gross in order to recognize or express it is happening, but to recognize the reality. And including the sense perceptions. The sense perceptions are seeing, hearing, touching, feeling, tasting. They are also incapable of illuminating that reality. So also the mind and intellect, which is the, if you want to say, the emotional aspect of our personality, emotional aspect, and intellect, the decisive or conceptual aspect, they both express as thoughts. They are also incapable of illuminating the reality. And why? Because you are that which is expressing within and without. Just like space is existing within and without, there is no place where the space is not. Similarly, this reality that you are also the substratum of everything. And to such a one, my prostrations, dehendriya pranamanodhyomi, yadanshad vidha pracharanti karmasu, naivanyada lohamiva prataptam sthaneshu tadrashtrapadeshameti. In the 23rd verse he says that 24th, that the body, indriyas, vital airs, mind, intellect, these are stirred into activity only when charged with a ray of the spirit. Just like the life on earth becomes active when charged by the first rays of the sun, the life begins on everyone gets up from the sleep. Same way, at a cosmic level, the entire creation, as if starts manifesting, as if gets invigorated when the first rays of light of yours, O Lord, illuminate them. And in during the wake, and what are the areas where they illuminate? They are the waking and the dream state, and not at other time during deep sleep. You are totally under, the human being is totally, the individual is under ignorance. So that time there is no question of illuminating, but we can say it is illuminating that also, or we are aware of that. And not at other times when they are not so charged. Even as iron which is not fully heated cannot burn, how then can they reach or comprehend that which is the source of their activity? You know, which iron they are talking about? We gave the example before of the iron ball put in the fire, but with that you cannot press. Even if our press is there, istri, if you heat it, if it is not hot enough, the crease will not move, go out. Na? So if it is not able to remove the crease, just like that, if it is not able to provide heat, similarly, how can anything illuminate you who are the all-powerful? How can the iron or this bulb illuminate the electricity behind it? It is not possible. You are the one who is illuminating everything. And therefore, Om Namo Bhagavate Mahapurushaya Mahanubhavaya Mahavibhuti Padaye Sakala Sattva Tapari Vrudha Nirak Nikarakara Kamala Kudmalopalalita Charanaravinda Yugala Parama Parameshthin Namaste. And therefore, my prostrations, glory to that Lord Sankarsana, the Supreme Person. See, the reality is attributeless and formless. The first expression of reality is this, the Supreme Person that is talked about, manifest, and that is this Lord Sankarsana, denoted by, and who is this? He is denoted by the symbol Om, and possessed of Supreme Light, and the spouse of Goddess Mahalakshmi. Prostrations to you, glory to you, the Supreme Ruler of the universe, whose lotus-like feet are fondly and softly kneaded by all the hosts of principal devotees with the lotus bud of their hands. And this way, the prayer was told by Narad Muniji to the Gandharva by the name of Chitraketu. And Shukdevji Maharaj continues. So this was the prayer. And now, Bhakta Shri Shuka Uvacha, Bhakta Yaitam Prapannaya, Vidyamadishya Naradaha, Yayavangirasasakam, Dhamma Swayambhuvam Prabho. He says, having taught this prayer to his devotee Chitraketu, who had come to him with a request for protection, to guidance, sage Narada returned along with sage Angirasa, Dhamma Swayambhuvam Prabho, and both of them went back to the abode of the Brahma, the Self-born. And during that time, Chitraketustu vidyam tam yatha narada bhashitam dharayamasa saptaham ambhaksha susamahitaha. And this Chitraketu, he started chanting this prayer which was taught to him by Narad Muniji for 7 days. And how did he chant? With perfect concentration of mind. Not, acha, sikha diya, thank you very much. Abhi khane ke liye kya hai? Not like that. He subsisted only on water. And that too only because throat was going dry. But complete concentration. How many days? 7 days. Try. No. Pani, so only water. What will happen? Give it a go, 7 days out of your entire life. Not a big deal. What will happen maximum? You will die. Soul never dies. We have seen that. Body dies. Next body aajayegi. Continue the journey there. Arre yaar, 3 days were left from the last life. Let me continue the sadhana. If that is the case, first 3 days you are liberated. Give it a go. These exercises are not just for a very good story. You have to practice. So, and what is concentration of mind? How do you define concentration of mind? Anyone?
Single-pointed mind.
What is single-pointed mind?
Focusing.
Yes, focusing mind, single-pointed mind, concentrated mind. It's one and the same thing. But what it is?
Concentrated.
That mind which? Other than? Lord can be also thought by 1,000 names. If you think of 1,000 names, you are not concentrated.
Concentrating on
Everything is correct. So yes, you can be concentrated on 1,000 names and you are not thinking of anything else. But even more concentration on one name of the Lord. So concentration of mind or single-pointed mind is that mind which is thinking technically, that mind which is thinking of one theme to the exclusion of everything else continuously without a break in the flow. With devotion and faith. That is single-pointed mind. Otherwise you do mechanically, nothing is going to happen. If that aspect of faith is missing and mouth is repeating for 7 days, kya kya? 1 lakh times I have repeated, nothing happened. That is why faith was missing, devotion was missing. You have to chant it with devotion. Like that, this is the last time. Pura jor dal do. And then, at the ततश्च सप्तरात्रान्ते विद्यया धार्यमाणया विद्याधराधिपत्यं सह लेभे अप्रहिति प्रहितं नृपः. एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द सेवन नाइट्स द किंग दैट इज द चित्रकेतु अटेंड परमानेंट लॉर्डशिप ऑफ द विद्याधराज द आर्टिस्ट्स ऑफ द हेवन. And how did he achieve it? By virtue of the prayer which the mind was still repeating. See, it was not that he stopped, now I become the boss and he stopped. No, he continued chanting the prayer. And he was fully illumined through the repetition of the same prayer. Chitraketu, who took himself to the feet of the Lord Shesha, that is the Sheshnag, that is the Shaya, the bed of Lord Narayana, who is even adored by the gods, and who is it will come, and then it says. मृणाल गौरं शितिवास संस्फुरत किरीटकेयूरकटित्र कंकणं प्रसन्न वक्त्रारुणलोचनमृतं ददर्श सिद्धेश्वर मंडलै प्रभुं तद्दर्शनद्वस्त समस्त किल्बिषः स्वच्छामलांतःकरणोऽभ्यवयान् मुनिः प्रवृद्ध भक्त्या प्रणयाशुलोचनः प्रहृष्ट रोमानमदादि पुरुषम् स उत्तम श्लोक पदाब्ज विष्टरम् प्रेमाश्रुलेशैरुपमे हयन्मुहुः प्रेमोपरुद्धाखिल वर्ण निर्गमो नैवाशकत्तम् प्रसमीडितुम् चिरम् ततः समाधाय मनो मनीषया बभाषये तत्प्रविरब्धवागसौ नियम्य सर्वेन्द्रिय बाह्यवर्तनम् जगद्गुरुं सात्वत शास्त्र विग्रहम् जगद्गुरुं सात्वत शास्त्र विग्रहम्. He saw the Lord in the form of a white lotus fiber, clad in blue and adorned with a brilliant ornaments, armlets, girdle, waist, kamarband, and with a beautiful smile on his face, reddish eyes, surrounded by the rings of Siddheshwaras. Who are Siddheshwaras? Those who have attained perfection. All his sins having been wiped out by the very sight of the Lord. Which Lord? Which Lord? Lord Shesha, not Sankarsana. By Lord Shesha. Who is Lord Shesha? Balaram Bhagavan. Lord Shesha is the thousand hooded Shesh Bhagavan.
Pardon me? Serpent? Is it a snake?
Yes, yes. In the photographs you see him that way. His name is Shesha. That Shesha is the first manifestation. And all his sin having been, Chitraketu that is, his sin had been cleared and all his impurities in the mind which express as Kama, Krodha, Lobha, Moha, Madha, Matsarya, they have been removed in toto merely by the presence of the Lord Shesha. And this Chitraketu silently went in front of the Lord with intense devotion. See, we may have devotion in our heart. No doubt you all have devotion in your heart. But when we come to Bhagavatam, it gets intensified. Why? Because if that devotion was absent, you cannot sit for 2-3 hours. Try sitting for 2-3 hours at home by yourself. It doesn't happen. When we are in a satsang, when we are in or some bhajans, there how time flies, you don't realize. So same here. The moment he saw the darshan of, he had the darshan of the Lord, he forgot and his devotion even more. Arre Bhagwan aagaye phir samne, Hare Ram, you know. This is what we feel that when Mahatmas come in, into our life, and we even more intense ho jata hai. Kya karu, kya nahi karu, samajh nahi aata. Should I eat? Should I talk? Swamiji, I had so many questions, but I can't think. And in that earnestness, in that wanting to do something for the Mahatma, for that realized master, here to do for that Guru Tattva, he is the, Lord Shesha is the Adi Guru. To do something for him, he was nonplussed. What to do, what not to do, kuch samajh hi nahi aa raha. यार ये तंग करेगा मेरे को देखो क्या है. And in this manner, and as he was standing in front of him, Lord is in front of him, tears are flowing, horripilations on his body, he is shivering away, the whole body is going through that experience. With that, he bowed down at the feet of the Lord, and therefore continuously he went to the feet of the Lord, and his tears were washing the feet of the Lord, and he wanted to say something, but the love that was welling up in his heart and mind was unable to be expressed. See, this is an experience, I'll tell you. And then having, he was not at all able to, for a long time, say any prayer with a loud voice. Why? The throat got almost choked. When Dhruva got choked, Lord touched him with a conch. So he's Om Yonta Pravishya Mama Vacham Ima Prasuptam, isn't it? When Daksha got choked, the Lord told him, I know what your desire is. Okay, go. My desire is also the same. Again. So don't think that you will experience God in a different way. Same thing will happen. And if it is happening, become more intense in that devotion. Find out. Drop all attachments at that moment. Forget about, oh, I have to pack lunch for my son. Forget him. Let him go one day hungry. How does it matter? Lord is presenting and you are thinking about your son. Bhagwan ka kaha, yaar, main itni mushkil se, itni dur se aaya. Kya karna hai? Sandwich bana ke de. That time, forget everything. See, when I went to Satya Sai Baba first time, I had heard so much of him. And after I finished the Vedanta course, and then I went to him in Whitefield for 4 days. Every day, by Lord's grace, I was getting the first row. And I was waiting, I was waiting, I was waiting. And I was thinking, first day, the feeling inside was, I have done Vedanta course, I am better than all of these, he must come and give me darshan, why not, I am more qualified than everyone. Why? I have studied Vedanta. By second day, thoda water down ho gaya, nahi yaar, I have studied Vedanta, but then if I am educated more than others, then I should surrender, I should understand that they need him more than I do. Thoda water. Third day, even more water down. Lord, if you come and give darshan, it's okay. If you don't give, I have already seen you. Thank you very much. And I used to sit in meditation. This third day, huh? 3 days mein itna kaam ho gaya. Fourth day, main kaha yaar, so acha, you are not. And every day he used to come in the corner, look at me like this and walk away. He may be looking at everyone. Everyone thought he was looking at them. I also thought he's looking at me only. That's how you feel. And that day, again, on the last day, I was sitting, I said, I had to go to Mysore that day. So I said, acha, today is the last day, Lord. If you are going to give me darshan, today is the chance. But anyway, I've been desiring. It's not the right thing. But what can I do? My mind is desiring. But anyway, I'll sit quietly. If you feel like, you give. If you don't feel like, don't give. I am not going to complain. I am happy that I had your darshan. And I said, and the Lord Satya Sai Baba came in front of me. And he stood there. And I didn't know what to do. I looked at him from down to feet. I thought he was so tall. He's very short. This was the first thought. But that thought came and went away. Then I, by the time I reached his feet, I saw his left feet. So I was like a, you know, Hanumanji, thinking, ab kya karu iske saath? So suddenly the thought came, why you are hiding your right foot? Why you are only showing left foot? So as this thought came, the right foot came forward, as I was thinking. And that right foot which was hidden behind, it came forward towards me and the left foot followed. And both the feet were right in front of me where this book is right now. Then I am looking at this. From the corner of my eye, looked here, looked there, everyone is screaming, don't touch, don't touch, don't touch. Not allowed, against the rules, and everyone is screaming. But I also didn't know what to do. And he understood probably, he made someone push me from behind, and I went and caught him like this. He would have fallen. How can he fall? He is the Bhagwan himself. I caught him and I put my tears were flowing, my forehead was on his feet, and it was a moment of eternity. Now everything stopped. For how long, I don't know. Only after coming out, then it felt it was only a few seconds. See? When you start feeling like this, every moment of your existence, then understand, Bhagwan is, the Adi Guru is expressed, is in front of you every moment. It is not one day you have to reach the Adi Guru. That Adi Guru is within, he is everywhere, without. That is the manifest Lord. That manifest Lord is not having a particular shape. He is the principle. That is why Baba continuously keeps going in wonderment. Kya chal raha hai? It's a wonderment. It's born out of Ananda, Paramananda. And in this manner, then he composed, Chitraketu composed his mind by reasoning and the outgoing tendency of his senses, and recovered the faculty of speech. Kuch na kuch karke, he brought himself under his control, stopped himself being carried away by the emotion, and addressed the following words to the preceptor of the universe. That means he is the Adi Guru of the creation. Who? Lord Shesha. Whose divine body stands described in scriptures as the Pancharatra, treating of devotion. So this is a prayer that he says. We'll read it, but I'll tell you in short. Chitraketuruvacha ajita jita samamati bihi sadhu bhir bhavan jitatma bhir bhavata jate picha bhajatam akamatmanam ya atma doti karunaha tava vibhava khalu bhagavan jagadudaya sthiti layadini visrusajate shanshas tatra mrusha spardhante prithak abhimatya. Tune thik nahi hai yaar. What is the tune?
Paramanu parama mahato swamadhyam tanta
vatti. See if it is Kayana Vacha tune. Ajita jita samadhi visadhu vihi bhavan jita atma birbha.
Sadhi tune
is. No, sadhi tune is. Paramanu parama mohatas
swam antaravat
varti traya vidhuraha Adavante picha sattvanam yadhruvam tadevam taralepi kshityadi bhire shakilavrutaha saptabhirdasha gunottarairanda koshaha yatra patatyanu kalpaha kalpasaha sahanda koti koti bhistadantataha. Okay, till here I'll explain. Otherwise you'll... See, he says, ajita jita samamati bihi sadhu bhir bhavan jitatma bhir bhavata vijitastepi cha bhajatam akamat akamatmanam ya atma doti karunaha ati karunaha. Who are you, O Lord? You that who are conquered, you are won by those righteous people who have subdued their ego or surrendered their ego and who are possessing the samamati bihi, those who are having an equanimous outlook towards life, towards everything. Only they who have this predisposition, they have won you, or we are using the word they have won you. Actually, it means that you only present to such people who are maintaining equanimous poise all the time. And no other person can win you or conquer you in any other manner. And who are you? You who bestow your very self on those who adore you with a disinterested mind. What is that disinterest is towards? It's towards the world. Those who have cultivated intense dispassion, disinterest, vairagya towards the entire creation and are seeking you, knowing fully well that you will present yourself only by your grace, not because of your willing, to such people who you present yourself because of your compassion. You are the one in whom evolution, maintenance and dissolution of the universe is happening merely as a sport. Tatra viva khalu bhagavan jagad udaya sthiti layadini. Udaya, manifestation, sthiti, maintenance, laya is dissolution. Visva srujate he ashashastatra mrushas pardhante prudhaga bhi matya. So, and the creators of the universe, Brahma and the other lords of creation, all those who are just a part of the entire cosmic creation are only a part manifestation of yours. They are not. Why? Because in each of your hoods, you see the Sheshnag, he's a thousand hooded snake, isn't it? A thousand means infinite. It is not, don't start counting 1, 2, 3, 4 thousand. It is infinite hooded snake. And on each hood of his, Lord Shesha is maintaining an entire universe in the form of the egg. It comes afterwards. And in that, for that entire universe, there is a Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. And how many heads the Sheshnag has? Infinite. How many the universes will be there? Infinite. How many Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh are there? Infinite. Oh, but we thought Vishnu is only one. No, you think wrongly. Narayana is one. Vishnus are many. Corresponding, if you take him as the part of creation, maintenance and destruction. Adhishtan Devta of that. So, in this manner, you are that. You exist before the atom and at the end of the infinite universe and likewise pervade the intermediate stages too. While you are without beginning, middle or end, that which is constant at the beginning as well as at the end of phenomenal existence is constant in the middle too. So what is that principle which is existing in the beginning, in the middle and in the end, and yet it is continuously existing? What is that? That you are. Is it space? No. But we can understand. Space is there before I was there, this body was there, space is there while this body is expressing in and through the body, and the space is there after this body goes away also. Isn't it? But this Adishesh, space is inert. It's only a material. It's an absence. Here we are not talking about an absence. Thinking of space, you will never get tears coming out. You will never get harubulations. You will go into ignorance. You will go into deep sleep by thinking of space. So don't think of space. Think of the presence in the space. Then you will get to this Adishesha. According to the Kundalini Shastra, when the Kundalini comes to the Sahasrara, that Sahasrara is this Adishesha Bhagavan. Thousand petaled lotus is the thousand hooded Shesha Bhagavan. This egg-shaped universe, which further resembles a bird, in as much as it is enveloped, they say, by seven sheaths in the shape of earth, outer, each outer sheath being 10 times thicker than the one enclosed by it, is swimming within you like an atom, along with countless millions of other similar eggs. We are not saying, Bhagavat is saying, that one egg, which is this entire cosmos, which is made up of the seven sheaths, is swimming in you, along with many other. हम अपने मैं मेरा हस्बैंड मेरी बीवी मेरा बच्चा ऐसे हुए. You know, there we Praveen sent one email once, when he gives that email gives the comparison of the Earth with respect to the Jupiter, Earth with respect to Sun, then the Sun with respect to the galaxy, only a tiny dot. So first Earth was a small dot compared to the Sun, then Sun is a small dot compared to a galaxy, then galaxy is a small dot compared to the huge cosmos. And on that Earth, which is non-existent now from a cosmic point of view, मेरी बीबी मेरा बच्चा, so important, such strong ego. From the cosmic point of view, you don't even exist. But we are so naive. I am the most important person in the world. Ego can never be the most important person in the world. And the self can not but be the most important person. Even if he tries, no, I don't want to be. He is. And therefore, Mahatmas, when they dissolve their ego, automatically they become the most important person. Everyone runs to them. Everyone seeks their company. Everyone feels comfortable in their company. If nothing, just hang around. They are brutes in human. Now this is important one. 38th verse. Vishayatrusho nara pashavo yaha upasate vibhutir naparam tvam teshama shisha isha tadanu vinashyanti yatha rajakulam. He says, they are really brutes in human form who in their thirst for the pleasures from the world of names and object of forms or the world of objects forget you and seek the world. We all want shanti, we all want happiness, we all want bliss, we all want tranquility. The one who can give us bliss, that in him itself we have forgotten. And that which can never give us tranquility and peace, after that we are running. This is a wonder. This is not written here, I am telling you. I am reading between the lines. So he says that, and what he says is that those brutes, those rakshasas in human form, who worship the world for sense pleasures and have forgotten your infinite glory, even though they are nothing but sparks of your glory, but they have forgotten you. The blessing enjoyed by them as gifts from the gods, O Lord, perish after those gods, after they perish, and come to an end after the extinction of that house. All these people, all these egos, all these individuals, they come, the individuals, those who do not know the truth, those who are not become one with the Lord, those who are not merged with the Lord, they seem to think that they will perish with the death of the body, and therefore there is fear. Even though, and they fail to recognize that they are the sparks of that same divine. This is from devotional point. For devotion, Lord Shesha is the ultimate. For Vedanta, attributeless, formless reality, Narayana is the ultimate. Understand this. So don't get confused. Even though they are made out of you, or the nature is nothing but yours, who are possessed of a body which is all consciousness and a product of these three gunas, even for the pleasures of the senses, O Supreme Lord, do not make for rebirth any more than fried seeds put forth shoots. For a pair of opposites such as likes and dislikes which lead to rebirth proceed only from the three gunas. And who are you who are in control of the three gunas? Who? Lord Shesha. He is in control of the three gunas. And therefore, he is continuously equanimous towards all the pairs of opposites. And what are the pairs of opposites? At the level of body, it is comfort and discomfort. At the level of breath, it is hunger and thirst. At the level of mind, it is joys and sorrows born out of likes and dislikes. At the level of intellect, the duality presents itself as praise and insult, or honor or dishonor. These are four main. All other issues come under all these four headings. That's all. And who are you who are equanimous to all these? Why you are equanimous? And as a result of this equanimity, the sattva, rajas, tamas, the maya is unable to disturb you. And in this way, you are entirely free from them, and therefore people adoring you even with an interested motive gradually get rid of the three gunas. So see, today the children were there, youth were there, and they are saying, Swamiji, this is, and one guy was going, as we are chapter 2, verse number 10 to 31 we are doing, highest, when Arjuna asks, tell me that which what is for my highest good, because I am your disciple and devotee. So Krishna says, okay, here you go, and he gives the highest, that you are the one which is the changeless principle. Everything changes, but you are the changeless. And this fellow, and I gave them the example of water, gold, mud, etc. And they are going. And I said, you are, what is changing? World is changing. They are saying. I said, what else? The body is changing. What else? Senses are changing. What else? Thoughts are changing. What else? Emotions change. I said, how do you know them? He says, I know that. I just know it. I said, that one who knows is the changeless principle. And he's thinking, and the head started becoming heavy, and sweat started coming by the end of the class, and he started, I said, cool it. If you think so hard, you will have a spontaneous combustion. You have to enjoy the journey. Only when you are happily thinking about the self, then this burning sensation will not come. Then this frustration will not come. You have to maintain the equipoise. Otherwise, when we go into it, heat is generated, and heat can go both ways. You can go into that energy that is getting generated as a result of intense concentration. If that goes into, this is crazy thinking, then that thought will become strong. I said, think about it coolly. Enjoy the process. He says, a child do that. The same way here also, that even if we merely remain interested in knowing the Lord while doing all our activities, how do you remember the Lord while doing your activities? Keep chanting His name. That's all, with love and devotion. oh, that is too difficult, how can we do it 24 by 7? Then light a lamp in the morning, light a lamp in the evening. You think I was born doing aarti and became a sannyasi or what? Lamp leke, paida. Meri mummy mere ko thank deti. Kahan se aa gaya ye? Nahi. We only were comfortably, we used to go to the temple. We are never overly religious. We are never overly doing anything in life. Never in my life I chanted Rudram. Never in my life I chanted any mantra except Gayatri mantra. And maybe afterwards Om Namah Shivaya. I used to wear, when I was in Switzerland, I used to wear, when I started eating that wind, air, I used to eat air because no money in the pocket. So I used to eat air and survive. So at that time, one day I went to a shop and I saw a skeleton as a key ring. I took that, put a black thread into it and I hung it here. Everyone used to say, hey, why you are wearing a skeleton? It looks yuck. I said, it reminds me what I actually am. I'm nothing but bones. And I'm so good. And I don't have to survive because of this. एकदम अवधूत की तरह रहते थे उस समय, पागल की तरह, आंखें एकदम पागल हो गई थी. So let it not be a very क्या कहते हैं, forced journey. जितना, the more you force, the more every action has an equal and opposite reaction. The more you force something away, with a double force it will come back to you. If you force anger away, it will come back. If you force wife away, she will come back. I will realize with you. Vice versa, huh? One couple was saying that Swamiji, he continuously he says, Swamiji, aap bataya na wo couple jo hai Hobart ke. He says, Swamiji, she is going so fast ahead on spirituality, I am falling behind. Please bless me so that quickly I come to her. She says, nahin, 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 Swamiji, usko wahi rehne do. Bekar mein mere ko pakda gaya, saadi pakda ke khada rahega. So, mere ko jana hai aage. So, ye sab theek hai, majak mein theek hai, but when you are making a on your journey, when we hear a satsang or something, sometimes this inspiration comes, oh, let's drop that. Don't drop anything. Continue your journey. Whatever needs to be dropped will automatically drop. Man mein aise nahi aana chahiye, itni der se mere ko, I think my reason of bondage is her or him. Lord, please take him or her away. Then I will be. If that feeling is there, it will never happen. Then that fellow or filly will live longer to trouble you. And don't tell me that these thoughts don't come in your mind. So, never wish that. If you wish that, for samajho, that person who was supposed to die a natural death will have an extended life. Why? Because you have the thought that he should drop away or she should drop away. So you be content with only one thing, and that is remembering the Lord. And when he feels ki you have matured, Urvarukumeva bandhanat mrityor mukshiyamamrithat. You know, although you all know that mantra, na? Trembakam yajame. Urvarukumeva bandhanat. Automatically, when you are ripe, the mother plant leaves you. You don't have to leave the plant. The plant leaves you. So, fruit is born from that plant. You are born in this creation. When you become ripe, the creation leaves you. You don't have to leave the creation. That is the blessing of the Lord. So you preach, O Lord, you preach the flawless Bhagavata Dharma, the easy means of attaining the Lord as taught by the Lord Himself, which even sages like the great Sanat Kumaras of loving devotion of the Lord transcend, which transcend all the four objects of human pursuit, including liberation, is therefore known as the fifth object. What are the four Purushadas?
Dharma,
Artha, Kama, Moksha. And what is the one beyond moksha, beyond all these? Because we tend to put effort for following the dharma, we put effort to satisfy the desires, we put effort to earn wealth, we put effort towards liberation. And who's beyond all these four? Is that fifth Purusharth. Just like we have the Turiya Tattva, doesn't mean there is a fourth state. It's just for the matter of speaking, indicating. Similarly, this Panchama, the fifth Purushartha, is the Lord Himself. And if, when we come to that point, this is 41st verse. Vishama martina yatra nrunam tvam aham iti mamata veti chad yadan yatra. Vishama dhyarachito yah sa yah vishuddha kshayishnura dharma bahula. So, when we come to know you, O Lord, when we come to know or merge into this fifth Purusharatha, the divine, the self itself or the Narayana, the notions of I and mine, the notion of I and you, all these vanish. This duality is present only in the ephemeral plane. But in the divine plane, if we can call it the divine, there is no duality. And such, even though such a person is seen roaming around in the world, but and he may be using the words I, mine, you, everything, but those words do not corrupt who he is. See, we see Mahatmas, Ramana Maharishi also used to say I. He will also say my cow, Nandini, what he had. He will also say my mother. But when we say my mother and when a Mahatma says my mother, there is a big difference. No impression is created. He does not fall into duality. He is not attached to that thought or name or form that is being spoken or interacted with. He continuously remains equanimous. As they do in the case, mine and your, do not disturb the mind of men treading on this path. Such people remain undisturbed on the path of their, in the pursuit and through devotion towards you, as they do in the case of other cults, such as cult of rituals, etc. A ritual act which is performed by one having a differential outlook is indeed impure, because characterized by likes and dislikes, yields a perishable fruit and is fraught with sin. So whenever a ritual act is done, it should be done with love for the Lord, not for yaar, isne bulaya, ye to dakshina kam deta hai yaar. The people are there and they will not accept that person. They will not go to the puja. When you know this fellow, Swamiji, dakshina is how much dakshina? Whatever you give, if you feel like giving, acha, 5 cents. It's only token. I don't mean to insult you, but it is a token you only said. Hope you don't mind. No. Acha, Swamiji, please come for dakshina, bhiksha next time. Suddenly the 5 cents come in front of the eyes. नहीं यार नहीं 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 ठीक है मेरा पेट भरा हुआ है. Why? You took the insult. That's why you are feeling that way. So those people who do rituals, they are doing it not for themselves. They are doing it with a expectation of a result. That result could be whatever. It could be monetary, it could be spiritual attainment, some siddhis, powers, etc. Such rituals, even taking the name of the Lord for siddhis, for something in the world. We do Satyanarayan Puja for what? Not for Satyanarayan Bhagavan. We do it with a sankalpa, pre-ordained sankalpa, that I will do Satyanarayan only if you make my son pass. If he passes, then I will do Satyanarayan. Adhogaya. See, isn't it? Satyanarayan Puja is done only for satisfying some desire in this world. So, don't get into that. That is fraught with sin, it is told here. What good can be expected either to oneself or to another, and what object can be gained through a ritual which is harmful to one's own self as well as to others? On the other hand, pain is inflicted on you through self-mortification, and sin is also incurred as well as your displeasure through persecution of another. So don't speak evil about other people, don't talk bad about other people, don't gossip about other people, don't harm other people, don't dislike other people, don't hate other people. See? Because by doing that, you are only hurting yourself. It will come back twofold. So rituals done with some motive in mind and not for the divine, they are sinful. And also all the austerities that are done, austerities, tapasya, all tapasyas that are done in by torturing the body and the mind, they also do not yield any fruit. Only a funny personality. You have seen those people, some of the Mahatmas you must have come across, especially the yogis, their eyes are swollen. Have you seen? Dekha hoga, kahiyon ka dekha hoga. Yeah, upar ka itna phool jata hai, niche ka phool jata hai. Yun karke dekhte. All those are gone through austerities. Arun Maharishi's eyes, no swelling anywhere. Absolutely calm as ocean, isn't it? When you see swollen eyes, understand, this fellow has gone he is trying too much, he is putting effort. Kundalini jagrit kar raha hai. Dam laga raha hai. But see Satya Sai Baba's eyes, see Ambachi's eyes, see that photograph there. See Raman Maharishi's eyes, calm as ocean. But you see, any Kriya Yogi, any Hatha Yogi, all of these things are swollen. Energy bhari hui hai. Ab kahan jana hai pata nahi. Bhari hui hai. All those are wrong ways. I'm just giving you indication. If you see her eyes in the window, in the mirror, are yaar, meri bhi bhool gayi. Why it has swollen? Because you are concentrating too hard. That concentration must be coupled with relaxation. In a relaxed way, concentrate. Understand, maximum concentration is only possible when you are 100% relaxed. In fact, 100% concentration and 100% relaxation is one and the same thing. But if you are putting efforts, you may attain concentration, but this will be the result. I didn't know that. Now check. Your point of view in the 43rd verse. Navyabhicharati tavekshayaya yabhihito bhagavato dharmaha sthirachara sattva kadambeshva prithak dhiyo yamupasate tvaryaha. Your point of view, that is, that people should achieve the object of their life through devotion to you, with which, as a matter of fact, you preach the cult of devotion, the cult which is exclusively followed by the worthy who regard the multitudes of living beings, both mobile and immobile, as their very self, is never belied. So, The path of devotion is for this, at this point, for this Lord. He is the Lord of devotion, if you may say. And what is the conclusion when you attain oneness? That you have the experience that you are expressing through all the inert as well as the sentient and the insentient. That is your experience. So when we say that in the on the seat of meditation, you withdraw from the individual intellect and you go to the total intellect, this will be the experience. It is not at all impossible that all the sins of men should be wiped out by your very sight, when it is known that even an outcast is free from the bondage of birth and death by hearing your name only once. Therefore, O Lord, we now have the impurities of our heart in the shape of sins and evil proclivities wiped off by your very sight. How could that which was predicted by the divine sage Narada, your celebrated devotee, be otherwise? All that is done by the people in this world, O infinite Lord, is known to you, the soul of the universe. Understand, there are not many souls. There is not 1, 2, 3, how many? 20 people, there are not 20 souls. There is only one soul. How do you know? Give example. This light, if it is covered by a black cloth, and in that black cloth there are many holes, how many lights you will see? That many holes, as many holes. So, because you are unaware of the source of light behind the cloth, your experience is many, many lights, isn't it? So, you think there are many lights, but actually there is only one light. So, now think, move away from this black cloth with many holes to the black sky with many holes. How many stars are there? Infinite number of stars. They are of the nature of light, isn't it? Who is expressing as those illumined lights?
Sun.
How can it be sun? You said sun. No. If you take this entire sky to be upside down umbrella in which there are many holes, and those holes are expressing as the night sky with the stars, there must be one light which is expressing as all those lights. It's an idea, it's a simile example being given. So who is that light which is expressing through all those? Without whom those stars would not have the light of their own. Think, the eyes. Who is illuminating all these five senses? There must be someone, the mind. Who is illuminating all the thoughts in the mind? Mind and that their mind and intellect is the same thing. The consciousness. That consciousness, when you come to this point, you have come to our Lord. It's a way of looking at the whole thing. And it is that way. The entire, remember, you are not a product of this creation. The creation is your product. If your eyes were not open, alive or able to see, there is no meaning of all the stars in the sky. You are most important because you are illuminating the sun and the stars. And eventually when you come back to that one who is the soul within you, who is for whom the mind functions, for whom the senses function, for whom this whole world is, that undeniable principle called soul, which is the Adhishtan Devata of this entire manifest creation, or many creations, if you can come to that, is this Lord. So it is not that. And what is, when you come to this, what you call super soul, or if you may call it, some Mahatmas call it as super soul or supreme soul. When you come to that, then what happens? That person starts recognizing that, hey, I alone am expressing through all the bodies. I alone am expressing through all the space, air, fire, water, earth. And this becomes an undeniable experience of that seeker who has merged or attained that state. Remember, three steps. First was jivatva. We began this chapter. Jivatva. Jiva. From jiva to Paramatma. This jiva is the, we think this jiva at our individual body level come to jiva, but then recognize that this jiva is only one, not many. Yoga Sutra says there is one jiva per, Sankhya philosophy says there is one jiva per person. But we don't accept. Vedanta doesn't accept. Even Bhagavatam doesn't accept. It's only one soul, one jiva, which is appearing as many. There is one ocean appearing as many waves. There is one gold appearing as many ornaments. There is one soul appearing as many individuals. Rhymes same, no? Now you have to realize it. How? Without too much stress, tension, forced concentration, nahi. Happily keep that thought, keep ruminating over these ideas, and it will click one day. The journey has to be joyous, not stressful. And this way, see, there's another thing that is told here, and that is that everything that is happening in our life is known by the Lord, isn't it? So whether it is happening good or whether it is happening bad is happening, whether there are opportunities or there are obstacles or anything that is taking place, He knows it. You remember the story in the beginning of Bhagavatam, where Narad ji went to Lord Narayana and he said, Lord, please make me, I love that girl. No, he asked, please tell me what is Maya. The moment he asked, what is Maya? Matlab bachchu pas gaya. Then immediately Lord said, acha, what is Maya? I'll tell you, see, there is this kingdom. Why don't you go and bless that king? He's having a swayamvar, at least go and bless that fellow. Zoom, he goes back there. He travels very fast. Went to the kingdom. Swayamvar was going to start. He saw the Vishwamohini, na? That girl's name? Vishwamohini. She was so beautiful. Suddenly, there was a desire in the great sage Narada that I must get married to her. At the same speed that he had gone there, double speed he went back to Narayana. Please, give me such a beautiful form like you that she puts the garland only around my neck. Lord says, Tathastu, go. He went. Passes one time, two time, three time. Hey, kya ho gaya? I am the smartest. How come the garland didn't come around my? And every time she came, Narad Muni used to think, now is the time. And he used to stand up. And he stood up. And she bypassed him. And all the people in the Swayamvar started laughing. Then he will run away from this place. Oh, I think maybe she didn't notice my handsomeness. Quickly he will run down the line and again stand. Again she will come, she will smile at him without insult, because she wouldn't insult him to get a curse. So she just smiles and walks off. Again he thought that maybe she did not see him. Again he will run. 3-4 times he runs. And at that time, every time she bypasses him, everyone in the Swayamvar is laughing at the top of their voice. And at that moment, suddenly from the main entrance, Lord Narayana comes and she runs to him and puts the garland around his neck. And the Lord Narayana tells Narada, how come you made me in your way? You are a thief, you are a trickster. And he, before thinking, because the anger, desire was there. See what desire does? Desire for the opposite sex, desire for the Vishwamohini. In that desire to possess her, he cursed Narayana, Lord Narayana. And after cursing, he repented. Arey yaar, kya ho gaya? Suddenly he came to senses. But already it happened. So he says, why did you do this? He said, you only asked me what is Maya. I was proving what is, showing you what is Maya, which cannot be explained. Now you understand. So that great sage Narada, who is continuously singing the glories of Narayana, who has got continuous access to Vaikuntha, such a person, such a great sage, who is the son of Brahma, he also got deluded even after so much tapasya and purification and everything. Even after he has the entrance to the, he is continuously at the presence, in the presence of the Lord, still he got deluded. Then will not this be called as Leela of the Lord? And we become so serious, yaar, mere life mein ye ho gaya, mere life mein wo ho gaya. It is Leela. It is only to teach us something. Get out of it. Let it happen, whatever is happening. So here it is told that, O Lord, you are the one who is making everything happen and unhappen. You know everything that is being done by the people, because you are the instigator of all that. For you are the soul of the entire universe. Just like you are the soul of the entire dream and the dream world. Isn't it? Without you, can the dream take place? If you the dream... So you yourself are expressing as the dreamer, you yourself are expressing as all the people in the dream. Dekho kitni mazedar cheez hai. Once you wake up, then you say, "Arey yaar, nothing it was." Same way here, when you realize the Lord, you will say, "Arey, really, it was all me only." He won't even say that. But you can appreciate that in the dream, everything is yourself. You have only created the dreamer, and you yourself have created the dream people. They are not actually present. So, prostrations, glory to that Almighty God, the controller of the creation, maintenance and dissolution of the universe, the purest of the pure, whose true nature cannot easily be understood by the sensually minded seekers due to their notion of difference. Sensuality, desire-oriented activity can come only where differences, separation, otherness, duality is given importance. You can be lusty only for something which is other than you. There is no question of lust for your own self. There can only be devotion towards the reality. There can only be surrender towards the reality. There cannot be lust towards the reality. Because if that is the case, if obsession is the case towards the reality, it will never be, there will be no result. It will only create more tension, stress. In the 46, viditam anantam samastam tava jagadatmano jana hairihar rachitam charitam vignapyam paramaguroho kiyadiva sariturivah khadyotaihi vignapyam paramaguroho. You are the paramaguru. You are the adiguru. You are the ultimate guru of this manifest world. Guru can be only in the manifest world, isn't it? So the manifest guru for the manifest world is this eternal soul. And where is that soul? Yes, right now, catch. Recognize yourself to be the one. And therefore, Namastubhyam Bhagavate Sakala Jagat Sthiti Layo Dayeshaya Duravasitam Tatmagataye Kuyoginam Veda Paramahansaya Yam Vaishwasantamanu Vishwasruja Shwasanti Yam Chekitanamanu Chittaya Uchakanti Bhumandalam Sarshapayati Yasya Murdnihi Tasmai Namo Bhagavate Stu Sahasramurdne Tasmai Namo Bhagavate Stu Sahasramurdne. Right, tune aa gaya. Trial error karte karte tune aa gaya.
Only the last one is different.
So, the creators of the universe, Brahma and the other lords of creation are active only when you, the cosmic person, are active. Inspire them with activity. The senses of perception are able to perceive their objects. When you, the inner controller, are disposed to perceive the objective world and the terrestrial globe appears on one of your heads like a mustard seed, obeisance, prostrations to you, that great celebrated Lord with 1,000 heads, and on each head, how many universes, cosmoses he must be holding, how many eggs must be there. It's like a small kinkad, small grain. And to such a Lord, my prostrations, to which Lord? To the Lord with 1,000 heads, the Lord Shesha. He is the eternal soul. Shri Shukavacha Sanstuto Bhagavanevam Anantastamabhashata Vidyadharapatim Pritaha Chitraketum Kurudvaha. Duly extolled in this way and highly pleased, Lord Ananta spoke as follows to the said Chitraketu, the chief of the Vidyadharas. Shri Shukdaji Maharaj is telling to Parikshit Maharaj. And here, basically, he is praising his own disciple, his devotee. We can just read it quickly. Shri Bhagavan Vacha Yannaradangirobhyam te Vyahrutam menushasanam Sansiddho sitaya rajan Vidyaya darshanachame Aham vai sarva bhutani Bhutatma bhuta bhavanaha Shabda brahma param brahma Mamobhe shashvati tanu Loke vitatam atmanam Lokam chatmani santatam Ubhayam chamaya vyaptam Mahichaivo bhayam krutam Yatha sushupta purushah Vishvam pashyati chatmani Atmanam ekadeshastham Manyate swapna uchitah Evam jagaranadini jivasthanani chatmanaha maya matranyaya tadrashtraram param smaret yena prasupta purushah swapam vedatmanastada sukham chanirgunam brahma tamatmanam vehimam ubhayam smarata pumsaha praswapa pratibodhayoho anveti vyatiricheta tadjnanam brahma tatparam yade tadvismrutam punsaha madbhavam bhinnam atmanah tata samsara etasya deha deho mrute mrutihi labdvehamanushim yonim Jnana vijnana sambhavam Atmanam yona buddheta Na kuchyashma mapnuyat Smrutve yahayam pariklesham Tatapfali viparyayam Abhayam chapyanihayam sankalpat viramet kavihi sukhaya dukkha mokshaya kurvate dampati kriyaha tato nivruttir praptihi dukkhasya cha sukhasya cha evam viparyayam buddhva nrunam vijna vimanitam atmanascha gatim sukshmam natraya vilakshanam drashta shrutabhir matrabihi nirmukta svena tejasa jnana vijnana santushto madbhakta purusho bhave etavaneva manujaihi yoga naipuna buddhibihi swartha swarvatmana neyo yat paratmaika darshanam tvametat shraddhaya rajan apramatto vacho mama jnana vijnana sampanno dharayannashu dhyasi. Very, it's all Vedanta. Complete thing is Vedanta. Vedanta means the Lord is showing how He is the ultimate Himself. So, and at the same time praising the devotee who has recognized his non-dual status. Or his status. Here Lord Shesha is speaking, so we cannot say non-dual. He is praising the devotee for having recognized that he is the material and the efficient cause of the entire creation. Manifest creation. See, that is also a great stage. Don't just deny, oh, we are Vedanti. No, this is also. So what does he say? Yannaradangirobhyamte vyahrutam menushasanam sansiddhosiyata tayarajan vidyaya darshanachame. He says, oh Chitraketu, he doesn't say Chitraketu, you have achieved your purpose through the instruction which Narad Muni along with Angirasa has given to you, and by propitiating me and the prayer that was taught to you by Narad Muni, you are bestowed with my vision of me. See? The Lord is telling him, how will you feel? Humko koi bolta hai ki, ah, by the grace of Lord, you have come in my presence. Suppose one Mahatma tells, bada egoistic hai. We will come to that conclusion. Why? We are looking at the body. But Mahatmas can say that. Some people do not accept Satya Sai Baba as the Purushottam. Some people did. Where's the difference in your mind? So here the Lord is saying that you have achieved your destination. You have come to the goal that you sought through the prayer that Narada had taught. In fact, all created beings are the same as I. He says, aham vai sarva bhutani. Aham vai sarva, aham means I, sarva bhutani. Everyone in this creation is nothing but I. Arre bapre. Maja a jayega iske bare mein bas thodi der ke liye baith jao leke. Those who don't understand, you will enjoy if you just take that thought and sit with it. The Lord is saying, there is only one soul, not many souls, remember. And that soul, if he says I, it means that I is expressing in and through everything, because he is expressing in and through everything. Aham vai sarva bhutani bhutatma bhuta bhavana. Of everyone in the past as well as in the future, everything is I alone. Wow. I am the self, the inner controller as well as the creator of all living beings. The Veda, which as the word of God is identified with the Supreme and the transcendent reality revealed by the same, both are my eternal bodies. What? The Vedas are my eternal bodies. See? Then a man should recognize his own self as existing, extending through pervading the whole objective universe as the subject and the universe as comprised of his own self as the object of his experience. Are, is that possible? Is it possible to do that? What he's saying, a man should recognize his own self as extending, that means pervading, through the whole universe. Yes, at a relative level, this is what we, what is the goal to be achieved. That it is, I alone am expressing through Hanumant, I alone am expressing through Padmini, I alone am expressing through Raghavendra, through the dog, through the cat, every germ, every amoeba, every insect, every animal, every tree, everything living, everything inert, I alone am pervading. There is nothing that cannot, can be outside this. The whole universe is the object and I am the subject. One without a second subject. Subject cannot be two. It's like saying, I am pervading the teacher, I am pervading the son me, I am pervading the brother me, I am pervading the friend me, I am pervading the disciple me. All these are names. But I alone am expressing through all of them. Same way it is this entire universe that I am pervading. Loke vitatam atmanam lokam chatmani santatam ubhayam cha maya vyaptam mahi chaivo bhayam krutam yatha sushupta purusho vishvam pashyati chatmani atmanam ekadeshastam manyate swapna uttitaha. Amma, give them food if they have food and go. We are enjoying ourselves, sorry. Sorry, but no sorry. A man should, regard both his own self. Again, one more step further. First was that the entire objective universe I am pervading. The second step, I myself am the subject. And I myself am the object also. See? He should regard both his own self as the universe. That self itself. So the ocean is saying, I am pervading all the waves. And the pervading ocean is saying, I am all the waves also. And pervading the waves also. Dekho. Whole object as a subject and the pervaded by me, the prime cause, and even so both as conceived in me. So both the subject and object. Suppose we are at an individual level, how do we think? We say we have a mind. In that mind, the reality, the consciousness is reflecting, and that reflection expresses as I thought and that thought, isn't it? So this I thought is having relationship with that thought and the ego is created. But we are not saying that there is, now each person will think there is one mind and each and in every mind there is I thought and there is that thought. Now you take out many I thoughts, there is only one I thought. And that which is, that mind itself is the expression of that, the Lord. That itself has become that itself has become I. And this Leela is going on between I and that. This is what is being told here. Just as, and this is again what example I gave you, just as yatha sushupto purusha vishvam pashyati chatmani, just like in a dream a person experiences the entire plethora of beings in the dream, but actually he is himself who has become all of them. Same way, recognize that in the waking plane of existence. You cannot recognize in the dream, you have to recognize in the waking only. So recognize in the waking plane. So just like in the dream, you yourself become the plants, the animals, the walls, the inert matter, the mountains, the forest. And waking from such a dream, visualizes himself as lying in bed in a part of a room, realizes himself as awake while still dreaming, even so realizing awakeness and other states of mind, which is an adjunct of the jiva, as mere products of the maya, deluding potency of the Supreme Self. One should fix one's mind on the Supreme Spirit, the witness of these three states. The point is, recognize this and in the waking plane, contemplate that I am the witness of the waking dream and the deep sleep. In the second chapter, Bhagavan says, you are the unchanging principle. And how you are unchanging principle? The childhood, the youth, teenage, youth, old age, all are happening, but you have remained the same. If you identify with the body, you become childish, youthful, and old, senior citizen. But body has gone through the change, you have not gone through the change, you never feel that you have gone through the change, only when you identify. Same way, waking, dream and deep sleep, the avasthas are changing, but you are the same person. How do you know that these three states of waking, dream and deep sleep have come and gone? There must be some witness, isn't it? That you are. Don't only get obsessed by this waking world. You have to contemplate on all the three together. Know me to be that transcendental reality. Know me to be that transcendental reality, the real self of a jiva identified with which an embodied soul is fast asleep, is conscious of its deep sleep at the time, as well as the super sensuous gratification enjoyed by it. As we said, jiva is not one per person. But here when we are talking, we are saying behind that jiva is that one person. Behind all the dots of lights, there is one light, which is expressing as all the lights. There is one super soul, there is one soul, which is expressing as all these souls. There was one consciousness, which was expressing as many consciousnesses and persons in the dream people. Recognize this about yourself. Or recognize, when you think of the Lord, you will come to the same point. And so here it is told, the consciousness that runs through the deep sleep and the other states is one and the same. If the in the 57th verse, yade tavismrutam punsaha madbhavam bhinnam atmanaha tatha sansara etasya deha deho mrute mrutihi. If the aforesaid Brahma, which is my own essence, here Brahma doesn't mean Brahmaji, it here means Supreme Brahma, the Brahman of Vedanta. Here it is known as Brahma, they are said. Which is my own essence. Who is saying? Lord Shesh Bhagavan is saying that Narayana or that Brahma is my essence, which is forgotten by the jiva. It comes to be viewed as different from the self, and from this differentiation follows the transmigratory existence of the soul, which consists in passing from one body to another and undergoing one death after another. Why this transmigration, which is birth, death, birth, death, birth, death? Why is this happening? Why is we feel that is the way that one day body will die, the soul will go? It is so common among Hindus, Sanatan Dharmis. It is a good theory from the relative, this phenomena is going on, but why does he feel that it goes on like this? Because he has stopped recognizing that he is the eternal soul. If you put attention on yourself to be the individual jiva, then there will be transmigration. But when you recognize that jiva to be the eternal phenomena, not as an individual, but it is an eternal phenomena, who is expressing as all the jivas, then there is no death for such a person. Death, anyway, even as an individual jiva, there is no death. Only death is of the body. But a person keeps, the soul keeps transmigrating, the wave keeps dying and being born as another wave. Why? Because it has not recognized itself as the ocean. Same is being told. And one has to come out of this. Labdveham manushim yonim jnana vijnana sambhavam atmanam yona buddheta na kvachit kshama vapnuyat. Kvachit
shama.
Shama vapnuyat. Okay. Yahan pe chha likha hai. So I can, because kvachit chha becomes ta and sha, but it is not kshe. Okay, let's see. You see the in your book also same thing? Kshema. Kshema.
Kshema means well-being.
Okay. Because if you say shama, means withdrawal of the mind is not possible. You can say it that way also. So anyway, kshema apnuyat or shama apnuyat. So here he says that he who fails to realize his own essential nature after attaining here birth in the human form, this is like a danda after us, reminding us again and again, that he who fails to recognize the Brahma, the eternal, the attributeless, formless reality, after having taken birth as a human being, where can one hope to acquire knowledge of the self? In the heavens, you cannot. In the hell, forget it. In the other yonis, impossible. Why? Discriminative ability is not there. Consider, we must consider ourselves fortunate that we have the human birth, and in this human birth, we are able to appreciate these thoughts that are being presented to us. See? Just appreciation is enough. Journey will begin. But appreciate it from the depths of your heart. Acha acha, theek hai. Aise nahi chalega. That where can one hope to acquire both knowledge of the self based on the scriptures and wisdom direct, that is the direct knowledge of the self, such a person can get no peace of the mind anywhere in any yoni, in any loka. Only in human birth is this journey to self-realization possible. And we are lost in everything else other than the divine theme. Everything else. Ye bill pay karna hai, wo collect karna hai, ye karna hai, wo karna hai. Class kab khatam hogi? Swami ji, bhul gaye kya? Kal kaam pe jana hai, we have to go to work tomorrow, has he forgotten? This is how it comes. And here, Lord has given us the opportunity to recognize Him. And we are thinking, when the class will get over? When will my legs unlock? Pathetic. Pathetic. He must be laughing up there. Well, up there, he must be laughing inside. Another fool. Giving lecture, but thinking about knees. See? Giving lecture, thinking about time. Talking about me, but thinking about food. This is how we sabotage. We are never able to be single-pointedly focused or aspiring for Him. Always there is something in the world to come and take us away from Him. The moment we feel, सडनली एकदम से आंख खुलते ही देखते, अच्छा व्हेन डिड यू कम, आई डिड नॉट, गया काम से. ऑलवेज देर इज समथिंग. व्हाई? बिकॉज वी हैव गिवन सो मच इंपॉर्टेंस टू एवरीथिंग एल्स अदर देन द लॉर्ड. एंड एज लॉन्ग एज वी कीप गिविंग इंपॉर्टेंस टू एवरीथिंग अदर देन द लॉर्ड, लॉर्ड इज फार 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 अवे. Pardon me?
I have a question here.
What did you say?
That's the Maya's doing.
Yeah, Maya's doing is there. Maya's doing is, because of Maya, everything is happening. But you have been given a faculty called discrimination. You have been given an opportunity as a human being. You have been given the opportunity of studying the scriptures. You have been given the opportunity to understand what the goal of the scriptures is, what the goal of human life is. And yet, knowingly, we are choosing not to think of the ultimate destination and get distracted by everything else other than the Lord. Now, you can't blame Maya after that. If you are ignorant about all this, then we can say Maya was there. But now you know, and still you want to blame someone, not take responsibility. That is not done. Jaan bujh ke fire mein haath dal rahe ho aur keh rahe ho ki Maya ne jalaya, main to
we are putting blame on Maya, that is real Maya.
Ye bhi bhai, ye haan, ye to ustad nikla yaar. We are. Yes, हनुमान जी ने बोला, पकड़ लिया. You understood what he said? That we are blaming Maya. That itself is Maya. Catch yourself. The way you can come out of this is by not thinking about Maya. Think about the Lord. That's the only way to come out. Otherwise, we'll always try to find someone to blame. Here we have blamed Maya. And that's someone's wife's name. Huh? स्मृत्वे हायां परिक्लेशं ततफल विपर्ययं अभयं चाप्यनीहायां संकल्पाद् विरमेत् कविः. In the remembering the hardships involved in all worldly endeavor and the contrary results following from such endeavor, and even so bearing in mind the fearlessness consequent on the withdrawal from worldly activities, a wise man should cease from all volition in regards to such activity. So an intelligent person, if you analyze your activities in the world has never given you permanent happiness. Then if you have recognized this already, then do not get involved, do not give importance to that. Does not mean you withdraw from the world. कि अच्छा ऐसे भगवान ने बोला, चलो सब छोड़ देता हूँ. और फिर उसके बाद run away somewhere and keep thinking of all that you are left behind. Not like that. Maintain a position of poise, of equipoise, where in spite of being in the world, you are not, your mind is not disturbed, affected, attached, agitated because of the world. And the more you withdraw from the world, the more you shift your attention towards the divine presence within you, a sense of fearlessness will come. And I told you in the beginning that when this jivatva is replaced with the jiva, and this jiva is recognized not as one per person but one expressing as many, fearlessness vanishes. Fear, not fearlessness, fear vanishes. Even coming to the jiva principle, fear vanishes. Why? You recognize that I am never going to die as a soul, even as an individual soul. I will never die. Okay, this body is no longer useful, drop it, I'll go to the next. Fear gone. But even more so, when you recognize that the jiva is one, expressing as many, as if a husband and wife. Now it's about you all. Sukhaya dukkha mokshaya kurvate dampati kriyaha tato nivruttira praptihi dukkhasya sukcha sukhasya cha. He says that a husband and wife undertake activities for the attainment of happiness and for freedom from suffering. For from such activities, however, ensues, that means results, neither the cessation of suffering nor attainment of happiness. So by getting involved in worldly activities, never you will find the peace that you are searching. By satisfying your desires, you will never find the peace that you are searching. So then what is to be done? Thus perceiving the contrary results met with by men who think themselves clever, and realizing the subtle nature of the self which transcends the three states of the mind, that is the waking, dream and the deep sleep, states, rid of the craving of pleasures of sense, both of this world and the next, through one's faculty of discrimination and content with one's knowledge and wisdom, one should cultivate devotion to me. Evam viparyayam buddhva nrunam vignya bhimaninam atmanascha gatim sukshmam sthanatraya vilakshanam. Shift. What do you call? What am I saying? What is the third sutra of Yoga Sutra? Tada drashtuhu swarupe avasthanam.
That's the second one.
Eh? That's the third one. Now go and do homework. That's the third one. First is atha yoga anushasanam. Second is chitta vritti nirodha iti yoga. Third is tada drashtuhu swarupe avasthanam. Is it second or third? Is it second or third?
I thought the first one is chitta vritti nirodha. Second one is
first is atha yoga anushasanam. So tada drashtuhu swarupe avasthanam. So what you must do? Always put attention on the life principle within. What is that conscious principle? That alone can take you away from the suffering. And that conscious principle, that life principle, you call it God, you call it Divine, you call it Ram, you call it Krishna, you call it Namo Bhagavate Vasudeva, you call whatever. It's one and the same. But that's the only antidote. That's the only medicine for all the suffering and all the troubles and miseries that come into our life. Only that, thinking about that and eventually merging into that principle and recognizing, merging into that principle means recognize that principle as oneself, will be once and for all the removal of all the miseries and sorrows in one's life.
Drushtashrutabhir matrabihi nirmukta svena tejasa jnana vijnana santushto madbhakta purusho bhavet.
So here he says in the 62nd verse that the one who has controlled, who has invoked this faculty of discrimination and is content with knowledge and wisdom that he has. See, what is contentment?
Be happy with whatever is there.
Without?
With whatever is there.
With whatever is there. But what we do? We want to study more, more, more. This book, that book, this book, that book. This Upanishad, that Upanishad. If you are doing it out of joy, no problems at all. But if it is with an urge that I think this scripture was not able to deliver me to the self, now I'll take another one. Then that is also not. Chalo Bhagavad Gita. Arey yaar, chalo change the religion. Okay, go to that one. We'll keep shunting throughout life. First, remember, reality or the Lord is where you are right now. And the only way to have access to Him is stop running outwards. You will stop running outwards only when you feel that whatever is there, whatever you possess as way of material, as way of life, family, children, etc., as way of knowledge and intelligence, convictions, that is enough. You don't need anything else. Why? The Lord is behind every thought. Lord is behind your mind. Lord is the mind. So what more information is going to make you so wise? Wisdom is not from collecting information. Wisdom comes from recognizing the principle because of which knowledge is possible. And therefore, the scriptures say, the first step is shravanam, active listening. A bestest student, while listening, is not concentrating on the words that are being heard. He is concentrating on what is that power because of which hearing is possible. With that poise, he comes to the satsang and listens. Otherwise, we come, listen to a story, nice pravachan, interesting story. अरे स्वामी जी ने आज जोक्स ही नहीं बोले, serious ही serious हो गया, 3 घंटे बोर कर दिया. So where is your attention? On the words, on some drama that must. I'm not saying you are doing that, otherwise you can't sit for 3 hours. You must be interested in something. That is what is keeping you here. See? But if you want to, because reality can be caught, the divinity can be caught only here and now. To catch it here and now, the only way is be aware of that principle because of which seeing is possible, hearing is possible. Maintain that poise. Let hearing happen. नहीं तो कई लोग स्वामी जी क्या बोला क्या बोला प्लीज आई एम राइटिंग नोट्स कैन यू जस्ट रिपीट इट दैट मींस ही वाज नॉट लिसनिंग देन इन द 63rd एतावानेव मनुजैहि योग नैपुण बुद्धिभिः स्वार्थ सर्वात्मना ज्ञेयो यत् परात्मैक दर्शनम्. To realize the oneness of the Supreme Spirit and the individual soul, that is the sole interest deserving to be known by every possible means by men whose intellect has acquired acuteness through concentration. See, understand, to realize the oneness of Supreme Spirit with the individual soul. This Supreme Spirit and individual soul at this moment seem to be two separate things, isn't it? That light which is coming out of the black umbrella is thinking, we are thinking it is separate to the light at the back. But actually it is one and the same thing. So when you, it is not that you have to merge into something. You yourself redefine yourself. And that redefinition of your own nature comes about without any thoughts. It comes as a direct experience. Did you do anything to redefine yourself from a woman to a wife? It just happened, isn't it? Do you redefine yourself? Do you say anything to yourself that now I'm a waker? Waker happens. Dreamer also happens. Similarly, meditator also happens when you go into deep into meditation. Similarly, this jiva, when he drops his identification with everything that is finite, recognizes himself to be the eternal. And this has to be brought about by a single-pointed mind. Single-pointed mind is a purified mind, is equal to expanded mind, is equal to, purified mind? Yes, purified mind. Is equal to concentrated mind or single-pointed mind. All these are synonyms. carefully bearing in mind and acting up to his exhortation of mine with reverence, O Chitraketu, you will soon acquire true knowledge and wisdom and attain for perfection. Now we are talking about the phenomena. Lord Shesha is talking. Lord Shesha is the manifest form of the Lord. And he is saying that you concentrate upon me. You become focused upon me, and by continuously having reverence and devotion and faith towards me, over a period of time, you will be able to come out of this finitude of existence that you are experiencing and attain perfection. Shri Shuka Vacha Ashvasya Bhagavan Nittham Chitraketum Jagat Guruhu Pashyatastasya Vishwatma Tachantar Dadhe Harihi. Having thus Ashvasan Dena, matlab to give assurance, after having giving assurance to Chitraketu, who gave the Jagat Guru, the Lord gave him the assurance, who is not only the perceptor of the world, but also the soul of the universe. Pashyatastasya Vishwatma. There is not one Atma per person. Again we are repeating. There is only one Atma. That's it. And that is the Vishwatma. And disappeared from that place while Chitraketu stood looking. And with that, what happens next, we will tell you in the next episode. Iti Srimad Bhagavate Mahapurane Paramahamsyam Samhitayam Shashtaskandhe Chitraketu Paramatma Darshanam Nama Shodashodhyayaha. Bolo Sankarshana Bhagavane Ki Jai.